The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hello, welcome back to the English class. Let's start today's class with a simple quote. The nature shows us how to live, love and grow alongside each other. So, the nature helps us how to live in harmony with each other. Yes, so today let's move on to the next chapter. Chapter 5, From the Heart of a Tree. So, you can see a pep activity here. Solve this riddle. Write the answer in the blank. Depict it as a drawing in the space provided. So, we are going to solve a riddle. Are you all ready? Yes. So, you have to find the answer and you should write it there in that space given. And you should draw a picture of the same. Okay. Before I grew up to be a big tree, this is how I used to be. Hard, alone and tiny. In a fruit or a flower, you would see me. Can you guess who I am? Can you guess the answer? Yes, the answer is seed. So you have to write the answer there and you should draw a picture of a seed. Okay, yes. Now, open the page number 110 in your studio. Here is a beautiful poem about the journey of a tree. A large tree finds its beginning in a tiny seed. As we all know, the tree finds its beginning in a tiny seed. Let's see what a tree has to tell us, to tell the human beings. Before I became a tree. Keep your fingers where I'm reading. Once I was a tiny seed, Mother Nature cared for my need. I grew up as a shady tree, breathing the air clean and free. So, once it was a tiny seed and its mother, Mother Nature, cared for its need. Like your mother takes care of you and your needs, Mother Nature takes care of all the trees. I grew up as a shady tree, breathing the air clean and free. So, this tree grew up as a shady tree, breathing the air clean and free. Now my age is 23. So this tree is now 23. I have branches so many, four children to play with company. So the tree has many branches, four children to play with company. We also used to tie swings on the trees, isn't it? Yes. So the tree have branches so many, four children to play with their friends. I let worms eat my tiny figs. I help birds make homes with tiny twigs. So the tree lets worms to eat its figs. Figs means soft fruit with small seeds. So this tree lets worms to eat its tiny fruits. I help birds make homes with tiny twigs. What is the home of a bird called? Yes, you are right. Nest. So the tree help birds to make nest with tiny twigs. I sheltered the resting herds and the wandering tired shepherds. So this tree sheltered the resting herds. Herds means group of animals of the same kind. For example, herd of elephants. So this tree sheltered the resting herds, the resting group of animals, and the wandering tired shepherds. Do you know who are shepherds? Yes, the one who takes care of lambs. Yes, my roots trap the water underneath to refill a thirsty earth beneath. So the tree's roots trap the water underneath. Trap means save or collect. So the tree's root collects the water from the soil to refill a thirsty earth beneath. So the roots of the tree helps to keep the earth wet. So the roots of the trees helps to keep moisture in the soil. People breathe the air I give. Why don't people let me live? So people use its air for breathe. We know we all are using oxygen to breathe, and the oxygen is given by trees. We all know trees use carbon dioxide for breathing, and it exhales oxygen, and this oxygen is used by us for our respiration. It is the tree that help us for breathing. So without trees or without nature, we can't live in this earth. Our existence in this earth is impossible without trees and the whole nature. But we are destroying the nature by cutting down the trees. Actually, they are our oxygen suppliers. So by cutting the trees, we are putting ourselves in harm. Do you understand? Yes. So what message did you get from this poem? Yes, we should preserve the nature, and it is our responsibility to take care of it. I hope all of you understood the poem, isn't it? Yes. So preserve trees, love the nature, and live in harmony. Okay. Yes. So read the poem very well and write the new words into your file. And if you have any doubts, contact me or Adra teacher. Okay. Yes. So all the best for your second assessment. Do your best. We'll meet you in the next class. Till then, bye.